Christianity is central in Lanyu, a small island in southeastern Taiwan. Almost 90% of the island's 5,000 residents are aborigines from the Dawu tribe. Due to social changes, the number of people under 30 years old who can speak the Dawu language has dwindled. The UN agency UNESCO has classified the Dawu language as endangered. Language preservation is a challenge facing the Dawu people today. In order for the Dawu people to read the Word of God in their own language, in 1994, the Bible Society in Taiwan published the first Dawu New Testament in the Latin alphabet script. In 2019, they completed the Dawu Audio Bible. Next, they plan to revise the New Testament and begin translating the Old Testament, a project which will take an estimated 10 years to complete.
Dawu is a minority language.
汉化教育太严重了，以至于我们的小孩对自己的母语的这种学习，很快就流失。人才跟有智慧的都在这个教会界里面，大概都是牧者，所以只有趁这个时候，他们身体还健壮的时候，推上去，祷告上帝，如果他们愿意的话，有共同的看见，就这样去进行。
The
story of the Dawu Bible translation has something to do with a remote people group in the Philippines. The Dawu language is closely related to the Ivatan language found on the Batanes Islands of the Philippines. Both are part of the Malayo-Polynesian language subgroup. No other Aborigine language in Taiwan belongs to that subgroup. Starting in 1987, suitable Bible translators began to emerge, including pastors Wang Rongji and Zhang Haiyu in Lanyu, and three foreign missionaries who took part in translating the Bible into Ivatan in the Philippines.
They previously translated the
有相通，所以他们就跟圣经公会申请，盼望他们可以来翻译。除了吃饭，然后就是一坐在那里，就一直要讨论，而且要比较，人家怎么样翻的，所以我们必须要去比较，然后去看人家的一些版本。我们至少看了一些少数民族，菲律宾少数民族至少有十几本，不过老人他们很认真把。
Presbyterians, Catholics, and the Assemblies of God, a total of 13 churches in Lanyu took part in this translation project, which has brought them closer despite their tribal and doctrinal differences.
每一次都在一起来审查，就越来越熟悉。 越来越觉得就是，我们都是一个
teamwork。As the island of Christ, Lanyu's Tawu people are the first Aboriginal tribe in Taiwan to have an audio Bible in their own language. In 2019, churches in Lanyu formed a joint team to record the audio Bible with assistance from the Chinese Wycliffe Translation Association and several other organizations. The project took 8 weeks to complete, and the Dawu Audio Bible app was born.
能够很流利讲达悟语的这个人不多，那我们原来是希望能够用这个戏剧化的这种录制的方式，那但是发现就我们没有办法找到有足够的人员。他们优先让我们有这个有声圣经，我觉得是他们对我们族群的这个重视。
Revising and translating the Bible has its challenges. The annual cost is around $40,000. Also, the aging generation of fluent Dawu speakers adds to the difficulties. But despite these challenges, this island of Christ continues to carry the Great Commission while preserving and passing on the Dawu language and culture to the next generation.